Hey guys, welcome back to Evony with Genghis on server 68. So today we're going to talk about setting up a gathering general. So first thing you should do is go into the tavern and oh, look at there. I had no idea. I'm borrowing a friend's account because I wanted to do some refines and quite frankly, I'm just not going to waste refine stones on my main account just to show a video because those refine stones are really precious now. So anyways, so here is a gathering general for him. This guy specializes in ore. Let me just look at what he has for farming generals and see if this would be an upgrade. So he told me he has two queen jindiox, so he does. So there's one, and then there's this guy who gives a bonus, I believe. Yes, he does. And then this is a food specialist. And this guy also, is that two of the same general or some? Oh, so they changed order on me right there. Okay, so two of those food guys, and there's his other Jindiox. So no, that's not an improvement. But what you would do is go in here and flip around with gems, and you just refresh right here and try and get gathering generals. But this guy has five, and he's full of marches. So like he has five marches and five good food generals. So I'll just check his bubble, make sure he's good. So there's no need for me to do any of that for him. I'll turn on his gathering. Anyways, let's go to the that's where my forge normally is. Where is this guy's forge? Okay, right here. So let's go into the forge and see what we should be getting. So if you look at these set pieces, so agility gear helps with gathering speed, but we're not going to use that. Let's just skip right to champion's gear. This is the best gear. So all of your generals should have this. It will increase the gathering speed and it will increase the resources. So you'll get a bonus. So, and then after that, you should basically just grab, the ideal thing to do would be to have a dragon. So let's look at the champions set that you're going to use for sure. This has helmet, chest, pants, boots. That leaves the weapon and ring open. And what you could do is go into the dragon's gear if you're really serious about it, or if you're a veteran who has extra materials, and you would craft a weapon and a ring to get that extra 15%. Now, I don't have that because quite frankly, I've only been playing a year and a half and I don't have the materials to waste for that. So what I do, I use King's gear or for the weapon. And so King's gear, it has a good lumbering, right? Speed. And if we go the same thing on a sword, it has stone. And spear will have food and the bow will have lumber. So you could go with that, or you could go with the what used to be warrior's gear, but it's now general's gear, and it is also good at acquiring resources with increasing the speed. Now, with that setup, you don't really have to do the ring. But now let's get into what I do. This is the important stuff. So let's go on to, I want to get one that has a so this is a king's sword. So this guy has champion's gear, a king's sword, and the ring really doesn't matter. Now he has three books. I'll see if he has any other books I can add to him. Okay, perfect. I can give him this stone one to increase that. And then he has a ranged troop load. That's probably not ideal, but he has no other books there. And that was probably set up early on when he had a small amount of troops. Anyways, so how you want to refine these. Let's look at the Queen Jindiok, and this is done properly. So if you look here, politics, 1100, and then the rest of this is all 600. And the way you do that is you click gems up here. You click this to cultivate. You do not click the gold. So I'd click that, and then I would click only politics, and I would cultivate at the bottom, and it would shoot right up only on politics. And the reason you want to do that is right here.
The only thing that matters for gathering. Right there. Resource gathering speed. There's nothing else in here that has anything to do with resource gathering. So you want to cultivate only that. So once we've done that, then you should go into all of these. Okay, so this guy has done a little bit of refining. And you can see he has two refines. And that's what I recommend to people. Basically, figure out what you want the general to be gathering, and then you try and get refines for that specific type of resource. So I'll try and find one who doesn't have refines on. And is that the case? I believe I saw one where someone did not have any the proper refines on his general. And then what I was going to do was I was going to roll for you in front of you and show you what I would be trying to get. Let's just go ahead and roll on one. So this is a very good one. So this guy has rolled three different refines. Now, the only one that matters for this guy is food. You're never going to be sending him out for anything else because he is a food specialist. So let's just take a look and see what we got on this one. This one has lumber and ore. So let's give it a roll and see if we could get him some food. So all I'm looking for here is I would like to. Okay, so we got one food, 3.4. I would never do locks on your gathering generals. Just roll and basically just hope that you get two of the one that you want or something really good. Okay, so I just got 6% on that one. That's really good because it's out of 10. I'm just gonna leave that for this guy. I don't want to go over too much of his stuff here. This one has two food gatherings, a 2.7 and a 5.9. So that is perfect to leave. And now I'm just gonna look at this. I'm gonna look here. Okay, so I'll just show you what I did here. So I don't see any gathering on here on the chess piece. I just see some troop load. So I'm going to click this button here, and this will tell me what piece of gear, like what they can actually refine to, right? So if you look at the helmet has all these options. It can do gathering speed, it could do HP, it could do subsidy stuff. So we're on close, so there is no gathering speed on here. It's only load. So there's no reason to refine that any further. And if we go to the boots, and we click here, let's see what we can get on boots. And again, there's no speed, so it's only load. So you're just looking at the pants and helmet that you could do that on. Let's look at this guy. This guy has a food gathering, we'll leave it. And here, this is another food specialist and he does not have food. So let's try and refine again and try and get this guy some food. And he has tens of thousands of refined stones in here. So we got him one food right now. Let's see if we can, 5.2, that's pretty good. We'll leave that for now. We'll just tell him that we improved a few things and not too much. And here, this should be improved because it's a stone gathering. And this is a sword. So he should actually be changing that over to a spear if he can. Because a spear would be better for gathering. Does he have the materials? Yes, it looks like he can. So I will do that and I will just speed that up for him. I have his permission to do that sort of stuff. Okay, so we're going to, this is big, he should like this. And I bet the other one, I didn't even notice. No, so I was right. He did have a spear on that one and he has a sword on this one. And now he's gonna put a spear. And that has food gathering, so that should help him out as well. And we will try and refine this and get some food on there. There was a lumber. We don't want that. We are only looking for food gathering. There's a 1.4. It's very low. And if only this was ore gathering, because that would be phenomenal. Rolled 20% there. This is a 6.2. I'll just do a couple more and see if we can improve on that. A 10.1 and a 10.4 in case he accidentally went. Let's leave that for him and we will let him know. But basically, that's what you want to do with your generals. Okay. Let's see if there's anything else we can do here. This has ore. And he basically never goes for ore with this weapon. So I will see if there's an opportunity. This is an ore person. And she already has an ore weapon on the Queen Jindiok. And let's see what the other one does. I just want to see if I could kind of change some weapons over and help her. No, that's another ore. So that's just not going to work. And it looks like should probably completely outright change these refines and put them on stone or lumber for this person. And let's see if we could do that. And the reason I chose stone and lumber is because if you look here, that is the two red books that are on here, stone and lumber. Oops, accidentally saved that, but that's okay. We'll get rid of it. And let's see if we can find stone and or lumber. Well, there's a stone, 11.3. Let's just leave it there and tell him we improved a little bit of stuff. So basically, that is exactly what I would be doing with my my resource gathering generals. Once again, just to sum it up, when you are refining them, you should only cultivate the politics. I know it costs a little bit of gems, but just accept that you're going to pay some gems and you are going to get excellent gathering speed out of it. It'll really increase your resource take. And then when you do the weapons, don't lock anything in. Do not do this. Do not lock any of those in. Just do one roll and hope that you get one roll repeatedly and hope that you can jig one or two decent rolls for the gathering resource of the type of resource you want with that general. And make sure that you have all champions gear for these four pieces right here, and then the weapon, go with whatever you have. And then when you get later in the game, for sure bring in the dragon ring and the dragon weapon and really increase that speed and crank it up. But not everyone is there yet, and it's not a good way to use materials early in the game. So that is just how I advise people to set up their gathering generals. This is Genghis, server 68. Like, subscribe, leave a comment.